My name is Catherine Metayer. I'm adjunct professor at the School of Public Health, University of California, Berkeley. I'll be talking to you today about the work that we are doing to investigate exposure to pesticide in homes and the risk of childhood leukemia. So why are we interested in pesticide? Pesticides are everywhere in our environment. We use them at home. We could be exposed through any nearby areas that are using pesticide. And children could also be exposed at home. Another route of exposure could be through diet, where water, food, or breast milk could be contaminated with pesticide. We at the California Childhood Leukemia Study have surveyed many houses to document that, yes, families are routinely using pesticide and storing pesticide in their home so that the potential for a child to be exposed to those compounds is very high. Most of the time, pesticide used in homes are those to kill insects, and the main family of pesticide that was found is called pyrethroid. Herbicides, to some extent, are also used and found in the houses that we visited. So what are the challenges to investigate a potential association between exposure to pesticide at home and the risk of leukemia in children? First off, when we talk about pesticide, we should understand that this includes a wide variety of active ingredients that do have different chemical structure and properties. In the United States, there are over 800 registered active ingredients, and for most of them, we know little about the potential impact on cancer and development of cancer, not only in adults, but also in children. So what do we know today? Epidemiologic studies do support the role of pesticide, and those have been based on interview asking about pesticide used. And there is strong evidence at the moment from studies throughout the world that exposure to home and garden pesticide use is associated with an elevated risk of childhood leukemia. Most of those studies have investigated the role of insecticide and, to less extent, herbicide. We at the California Childhood Leukemia Study documented about 10 years ago that exposure to indoor insecticide increased the risk of childhood leukemia through our different critical windows of the child development, including pregnancy and early years of life. We were one among many studies around the world in France, Germany, Brazil, to document this association. This slide is showing you a summary of those results that have been published over the past 10, 15 years. And any association would be represented by a little square that is above one on the scale that is on the cartoon, showing that use of pesticide lead to an increased risk of childhood leukemia. And it appears that most of the time it's in the range of a twofold risk. Same overall conclusion, although based on smaller numbers of studies, do document that use of herbicide may increase the risk of childhood leukemia in the range of a 1.5-fold risk. So what are the practical recommendations? Although we do not know what specific pesticides are increasing the risk of childhood leukemia, it is safe to say that families should limit their exposure to pesticide during pregnancy and after the childbirth as much as possible. This could have benefits on reducing the risk of childhood leukemia, but other conditions that may be associated with pesticide. We also believe that the next generation of studies will be able to investigate the levels of those pesticides in the blood or urine in order to have a better understanding of the association between pesticide and childhood leukemia.